Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to NESA online classes. I am your course trainer, Bobby Bora, and today we'll continue our class on public area and laundry services from your core module. Today's topic is laundry and its equipments. Before we start our today's session, let's recall the topics that we have already covered in our last class. So we learned about laundry and its functions, different types of laundry that are on-premises laundry and commercial laundry, advantages and disadvantages of on-premises and commercial laundry. Let's go through the lesson objectives. At the end of this lesson, you should be able to describe the types of equipments in the laundry work area. From this slide onwards, we will learn about different types of commercial laundry equipments, that is heavy duty laundry equipments. There is a vast difference between commercial laundry equipments and domestic laundry equipments. Domestic laundry equipments is intended for use in the house and will be smaller and suitable for a family, whereas commercial laundry equipments is intended for use on a larger scale, either more frequently and for larger amounts of clothes, beddings, etc. Even the price of commercial laundry equipment starts from 1 lakh to 4 to 6 lakhs of rupees. Some of the top companies that provide commercial laundry equipments are American Dryer Corporation, Fabcare, Unimec, and many more. Now let's go through some of the laundry equipments. They are washing machine, hydro extractor, tumbler dryer, calendaring machine, cuff and collar press, suji or puffer, spotting machine, and flatbed press. Let's go through the laundry equipments in detail. First is washing machine. Front loading washing machines are preferred for larger laundries such as industrial laundries. The machine rotates for 15 seconds in one direction and reverse direction for another 15 seconds. This prevents the entangling of linen inside the drum. The speed of rotation of the drum ranges between 40 to 60 RPM. RPM stands for revolution per minute. The temperature of water is selected according to the type of fabric. For example, cotton fabric can be washed at a higher temperature, whereas woolen, silk, and synthetic require lower temperature. The industrial machinery have a control panel which displays the stages in the wash cycle in progress, the time remaining for the completion of the cycle, the temperature of the water, and even the chemicals used is displayed. Hydro extractors. The machine which carry out washing as well as hydro extraction are called as washer or hydro extractors. Most hydro extractors work on a centrifugal action, and many machines has a single drum which does both washing and hydro extraction. The drum rotates at a very high speed, faster than the speed of washing machine, and the clothes are passed against the size of the drum, and the water passes out through the perforations and out through the drainage pipe. Depending on the fabric may be 50 to 80% dry. Tumble dryers. These are machines that dry linen by tumbling it slowly in a perforated drum, exposed to hot air raising from 40 degree to 60 degree Celsius in low capacity dryers and going up to 85 degree Celsius in industrial dryers. The machines may be programmed for delicate articles with low or no heat. Most dryers have microprocessors, computer control system. The length of cycle is depending on moisture absorbency of the fabric, whether it is to be completely dry. appropriate time is 30 to 40 minutes. Clothes requiring a pressed finish are subjected to various types of finishing equipments depending on the size and shape of the linen. One of the finishing equipments is calendaring machine. These are needed for ironing flat pieces of linen such as bed sheets, tablecloth, blanket, serviettes, etc. This machine consists of a series of rollers in pairs connected by a narrow conveyor belt. The speed of the roller is adjusted. The bed sheets or other flat articles, linen, are fed manually. The linen passes through heated roller, thereby they become ironed. After pressing, the sheets can be automatically folded or can be done manually. Cuff and collar press. These press consist of spring-loaded bucks. The collar and cuff of a shirt are placed on this to get a uniform pressed finish. Basically, cuff and collar press is used to iron cuffs and collar of shirts. Now, let's talk about suji. The suji is also known as puffer and is used for coats, jackets, and articles that do not crease heavily. It is an air foam bag that shakes the garment with a gentle cushion of steam and hot air to restore them to their original appearance. At first, steam is blown into the dummy and then hot air is blown to remove the moisture created by the steam. Spotting machine. This machine is used to remove stain from different types of linen. The process of removing hard stains from linen is known as spotting. Spotting machine consists of a spotting board, a spotting gun, and the steam attachment. A spotting board is a table that is partly perforated. The surface is hard and made of stainless steel or any other material resistant to acid, alkaline, and stain removing agents. Let's talk about flat bed press. It is suitable for automatic pressing, ironing of various types of garments like trouser, linen, table covers, napkins, saris, staff uniform of hotels, hospitals, etc. In the previous slides, we learned about different types of laundry equipments. Now, let's go through a few of the items which plays a vital role in a laundry. First is folding table. Folding table is a handy option for any laundry room. It is the perfect place for sorting colors before washing and folding the clothes as soon as they are dry. Now, let's talk about linen trolley. Linen trolley is used to carry dirty linen, clothes, napkins, towels, etc. It is also extremely useful for distributing linen in floor pantries and in linen room. Let's sum up today's learning. Today we learned about different types of laundry equipments and functions of different laundry equipments. It is very important that you should have proper knowledge about the equipment before you operate it. As the laundry equipments are very costly, the hotel usually hires qualified and trained staff to operate them. It is also important that equipments are checked and serviced on a regular basis for their longevity. Dear students, I hope you all enjoyed our class today. Today we learned about laundry equipments, which is very important in our hospitality industry. If you have any confusions, please do contact me. Thank you and have a nice day.